Takes us to the Carolinas and Bank of America Stadium here in Uptown Charlotte. Nothing like the fanfare of introductions to an NFL game, and that was in evidence among Knicks, you name it. This crowd is ready as their guys get set to match up between the Tampa Bay Buccaneers and the Carolina Panthers.
Zerline set to kick off.
The shadow's starting to get a bit longer. Week 10 of the NFL season is here, and we're underway on EA Sports. And up to about the 26-yard line, just across the 25.
At their own 26-yard line.
First play, and it's second down now.
Defensively here, you're facing a top five team in terms of points scored in the NFL, so when they're that high power, you've got to find a way to hold them under 20, because to me, that's the magic number. 20 points score, give yourself your best chance to win.
So if they're up around 24, 28, 30, they could be in some trouble.
And I think so, because then you turn it into a shootout, and that means your offense has to keep pace.
6 yards there off the scramble, but it'll still leave them with a third down. This is Melvin Gordon. And he went backwards. He'll be down at the 30.
He was taken.
That'll make it fourth down after a loss of one.
This defense is a difficult one to prepare for, one of the best in the league. They'll come at you from all angles, and they did a nice job there stopping him for a loss.
Pilardi now on to punt as he sends this one away. Taken in at the 11. And he is out of bounds right around the 34. Nearly a huge return, as it is still a very good one. 24 yards. And the Panthers will take over now, first and 10.
Get
two, maybe three, up near the 37.
Yeah, I don't know if it's exactly a win-win, but if you're on offense, you'll take that kind of a run, all right? It was kind of stacked up, found a little bit of yardage, and frankly, they're pretty close to staying on schedule on offense. The playbook is still open for the coordinator.
The last run got three. Now here's second and seven. Shotgun now for Carr. That'll be taken in there by Kenny Galladay. And they're going to have this across midfield and inside the 45. That one, a gain of 20 and a first down.
At the 43-yard line.
Working from the gun, it's Carr. Throwing deep for Galladay. And that is incomplete. He couldn't hold on through the contact. Brings up second down.
That's what you're going to need to do against those big receivers. You got to get in there and get physical with them. That time he got in close, got in tight, and knocked the ball away.
Into heavy traffic, and it's intercepted. Picked off by Marshon Lattimore. And they have possession, and they have it at the 38-yard line. He had a little bit of the turnover bug last week. Three interceptions. Not an absolute disaster, but another one here. Do you start to get a little worried?
You worry about your team as a whole because you have to find a way to make those interceptions, quote-unquote, go away. And that means your defense. They've got to go out there on sudden change and at least hold people to field goals. And if that keeps happening, they lose confidence in the quarterback, and then no one plays well.
He rifles one that's intercepted. He's picked off at his own 47. And they'll set up shop right near midfield at the 49-yard line. Well, not a good omen there. His first throw of the afternoon, intercepted.
And I know what the fans are thinking right now. I hope there's not negative thoughts in his head going forward since that's his first throw of the game. But one of the things I remember about him coming out of school is he's able to wipe things away pretty easily and move on.
Now after the INT, it's Carr. He'll get this one to Galladay.
That's good.
And he's corralled, but not before getting it inside the 35. Give him 15 there, and the Panthers have a first down. Here's a quick throw complete to Galladay.
Carr's pass.
And he is going to lose yardage here. That one unable to develop, never got going. A loss of a couple, and it's second down.
6-yard line.
From the gun, it's Carr. There goes a deep ball, end zone. And he's got it. Touchdown, Panthers. Preston Williams with touchdown number 7 on the year. And the Panthers are going to take a first quarter lead. And now a 2-point conversion attempt forthcoming.
If you didn't know it, it won't surprise you to find out that this team leads the league in score.
Into heavy traffic, and it's intercepted. Picked off with great anticipation. And a big turnover there as his guys will get the football back. So they went for two and failed. They didn't use him on the PAT, but now he boots this one away with a 6-0 lead. Takes this about 5 yards deep. And ultimately cannot get this out to the 25-yard line as he's dropped at the 23.
23-yard line.
The Bucs offense set to begin their next possession. They've shown precious little here offensively thus far as they try again with a first down now. They go back to the air here after the INT on the last drive. And this will be incomplete. Physical play on the football there, and it's second down. Once again, they'll go from the 23-yard line on second and 10. Throwing again is Watson. And that'll be incomplete. Took a pretty good shot as he tried to pull that one in. Couldn't hang on, third down.
Brandon, we saw these defenders flying to the football in their win last week, and nothing has changed. They're still moving around quickly and forcing incompletions.
Now they face a third and 10 after back-to-back incompletions. Back to throw, Watson. eluding the pressure right. Open man is Gordon, complete. And he is going to have a Bucs first down as they're able to get the third down conversion. A big one there on third down. They hit for 30 yards. Now Gordon on first down. And he is tackled inside the 40, not quite to the 35.
He's brought down.
10 more there and another first down.
It's a gain of 10. And they
go back to Gordon here on first down. And he'll get 3 down to the 34-yard line.
The ball carrier.
Not a whole lot there. The defense was ready, it looked, for that run-pass option.
You get the sense that next time he has that opportunity, he may keep it himself and get to the perimeter. Probably owes his back a little bit of an apology on that one, huh?
On second and 7, Watson. Pressure comes in. He's brought down. It's a Panther sack. Going to need something special here on third and long. After that sack, what does Watson have in his arsenal?
Third down.
Now it's Watson.
Third and long.
Oh, the ball comes out on the hip, but they'll say it's incomplete.
One thing that you're going to see from this offense is that they love the matchup with their wide receivers against this secondary. That one wasn't successful, but don't expect them to back away from attacking all game long.
They will indeed snap it to Watson. And now this is going to be close. The defense says they stopped him, and they did. The Bucs try it on fourth down, but come up empty. And the Panthers will get the football back. Throwing on first down is Carr. Open man is Galladay, complete. He'll be stopped at the 35, but not before he picks up 7 yards.
A 7-yard pickup brings up second.
Throwing again on second down. Carr got a man and he hits him in stride.
That's good.
And he slips up past the 45 before being tackled.
First and 10 at the 48-yard line.
On first and 10, here's Carr. Looking left side for Watkins and he's got him. It's a gain of 9 yards.
Complete.
And that'll make it second and short.
A gain of 9 brings up
6-0 our score after 1.
3-yard line.
Looking to throw again on second down. Carr, he's got his man on the crossing route. And this is going to lead to another first down as the tackle's made at the Bucs 28. A solid gain of 15 yards and the sticks move. Throw on first down there, but it's incomplete. Preston Williams, the intended receiver. And now it's second down.
Buda Baker there on the coverage.
To throw again. Carr letting one go deep for the end zone. He's got it for a Panther touchdown. And he showcased his blazing speed on that one.
Was he wearing football cleats or track spikes? Because he was gone. Big time play. And just think about what that does if you're
trying to get it to Williams, but it's intercepted. Good positioning, and it's picked off. He's at the 50. He's at the 30. 20.
Uh-oh.
And he takes it all the way back. It's a pick two, if you will, as that play backfires in a big way. Boy, I guess they're going to keep trying to put the pedal to the metal here. They're going to try an onside kick. And the Buccaneers able to recover. Their hands team does its job. A second quarter onside kick there that failed. Is that something that maybe they had dialed up before this game started?
It feels like it, doesn't it? That they thought they had the right situation, you know, and the right approach in going after it. Also may signal that they feel like they have the superior team, that they can try these sorts of things and it won't come back and hurt them later.
Down Gordon, and he's going to be met at the line of scrimmage and taken down. No gain on the play there. Second down. Well, if you look where that play starts, O-line versus D-line, that was a battle won by the D-line.
Yeah, and oftentimes it's won by quickness off the ball. Who can handle the guy across from them best? On that play, the defensive line did exactly that.
Throwing on second down. Watson. Into heavy traffic, and it's intercepted. Rashard Robinson with a pick. And they are going to set up shop at the 40-yard line. You don't see this often. A quarterback of his caliber, two first-half interceptions.
It's absolutely surprising because it happens so rarely. You're searching for what reason, what's going on out there. It's not just maybe the defense is playing well. Is his horoscope off? His biorhythms? What is it?
You went horoscope on us, David.
Well, I was thinking maybe REM sleep was off. I'm trying to come up with something.
Anything, right? Carr again here on second and 10. Looking left side, and he's got a man. That's Watkins. 4 yards the gain, and it'll bring up a third down.
It's a gain of four.
Bring from the gun, Carr. Looking left side, it's complete. He's got it. And he is going to have a Panthers first down as they're able to get the third down conversion. Catch number 44 on the year. It's a first down. Carr completes it. And he's going to get a solid gain of 9 before being brought down. Second and right at a yard. That last catch short of the marker by just a yard leaves him with a very manageable second and 1. A throw for Galladay is going to be intercepted. Picked off near the 32. And they will finally stop him, but a great return. Gets that football all the way down to the 16-yard line.
They'll take over first.
I tell you what, credit is due there on them preventing the touchdown after that interception.
How about him chasing him down and not giving up the pick six? Because what happens a lot of the time is when you see the interception, you just kind of hang your head a little bit and you momentarily pause because you're frustrated. He shook that off and gave great chase and got it done.
Still a great return and very good field position. On second down, they'll run with Gordon. And forget about finding a lane. He barely had time to look up before he was planted in the backfield. That'll set him back with a loss of 3 on the play. And they're going to have a third down. Gordon. And boy, he is very close to a first down. But from where they're spotting that football, he's going to be a foot or so short. It's a 6-yard pickup, but still a few chain links short, it appears, with fourth down coming up. And he's able to pick up the first before he's brought down inside the 5 at the 4. Just a gain of 3, but they'll certainly take it as they convert on fourth down. Now whistles here before the snap. Looked like one of the Bucks may have moved. They'll get neither the touchdown nor the first down. And the Buccaneers defense holds and they get the football back. And to give this time to the tailback. He pushes forward from maybe 3 down to the 6-yard line. The 6-yard line, the line of scrimmage on second and goal.
A gain of 3 brings up.
Now a handoff here to his running back. And he is going to be stopped cold behind the line of scrimmage. Now they'd really like to make the short field pay off. We'll see if they can, but this is third and goal. Watson. To the goal line, but it's incomplete.
Normally being a big-bodied receiver plays to their advantage downfield. Go up and make the catch, take the hit, and pick up yardage. But in this case, the hit was timed really well and popped it free from his grasp.
And in his 15th season, he's able to get this one to go. And this is back down to a 7-point game. That drive took him inside the 10. Good job defensively to hold him to 3.
Yeah, I like how you did that. Give a little tip of the cap to the stop troops there because they didn't give up a touchdown in that situation, right? Made them kick the field goal. And yeah, points went against them, but that feels a whole lot better running off the field.
And that decision to bring it out ends up not being a good one. Cost him about 5 yards as he's tackled at the 20. This Carolina offense at the line, ready to go. And you know, it's certainly a lot of football left to play. We're not into December yet, but right now where we stand, they're in first place in their division looking. Oh, this is taken in. It's complete. And they're going to have this across midfield and inside the 45. 36 yards on the play.
At the 44-yard line.
Carr now on first down. Man open left side. It's Williams.
Carr's pass. Complete to
5 yards on the catch there. Brings up second down.
Brings up
operating from the gun. Carr escaping the pressure right. Looking right side, and that's complete to Watkins. And they will only muster a yard here to the 38. They follow up the gain of 5 by only getting 1 there on second down. They'll find a man over the middle. It's Galladay. And he is going to have the Panthers first down by about 3 yards or so as they wind up getting 7 there on 3rd and 4. Oh, there's that man again. It's complete. Now the Bucs going to use the first of their timeouts, as he'll stop it with exactly a minute to go before halftime.
At the Buccaneers' 23-yard line.
Four receivers in the formation here. 3 to the left, 1 to the right, 2nd and 3. Carr to throw again. Flush to his right. And that one finds the ground, breaking a string of 5 straight completions. And it brings up 2nd down. No, 3rd. 3rd down.
Brings up 3rd down and 3 yards to go.
Now, Carr again. And this is caught by Watkins. And he is going to have the Panthers first down as they're able to get the 3rd down conversion. They'll get 9 out of that one, and as a result, the drive continues. That's complete right around the 8. And he couldn't quite get there. Tackled down at the 1. Now the Panthers going to use the first of their timeouts, as they'll stop it with 27 seconds remaining here in the second quarter. Carr. That's caught at the 2. And he will take it across for a Panthers touchdown. Third touchdown pass now for Derek Carr. And the Panthers add on to their lead. So now here's Derek Carr leading his guys up to go for 2. Again, they'll throw with Carr. Being chased out left. That's caught. And he will get into the end zone to extend the lead by 2 more.
Panthers 20, Buccaneers 5.
Now after the touchdown, it's Zuerlein. He'll kick it away. Fields it in the middle of the end zone. And only able to get this to the 19, so probably should have opted for the touchback. The Bucs offense set to begin their next possession. You're under 30 seconds to go. Field position not great. Time to call it a half, wouldn't you say?
Well, you know, we all have that little extra gene that says let's push the envelope a little bit, right? What needs to be going through the play caller's mind right now? A potential fumbled snap that can get returned. A strip sack that can get returned, right? Any of those types of plays, that should be a deterrent to calling something that could get you in big trouble.
So after the incompletion on first, now 2nd and 10. Not wanting to take a chance this time, they'll keep it on the ground. And he'll just keep 2 hands on the football as he'll be taken down after a short pickup. They do get a couple, but they'll be left staring at a 3rd and 8 coming up. So we reach halftime in what's been a fairly one-sided game so far, as we'll get you down the coast to Orlando for Jonathan Coachman at REA Sports Halftime Report. Coach! Looks like the Panthers' hands team does its job. A very interesting call, and one that backfires. I know they're losing, Charles, but boy, to start the second half with the onside kick, risky.
Felt like a sense of urgency from their side, coupled with, you and I both know, the special teams coordinators. They sell their key plays each and every week to the head coach, don't they? And I guarantee he's been selling this one. We can get it, coach. We can get it. And that came together with that sense of urgency you talked about.
Kenny Galladay, the Pro Bowler, was his intended target. And that'll bring up second down.
As soon as I saw him break contain and get outside, my first thought and my eyes gravitated downfield, because nowadays, most of these quarterbacks, when they do that, they want the big play downfield. They don't want to throw it short. In this case, he took the shot. It fell incomplete.
It's a gain of 35. Now a chance to make that big play really hurt. It's first and goal just outside the five. And he's got it. Touchdown, Panthers. Make it four touchdown passes now for Derek Carr. And the Panthers, they widen their lead. So now here's Derek Carr leading his guys up to go for two. He was on point throwing the ball right there. He had the big play to get him down close, and then he delivers a touchdown pass on first and goal.
And you mentioned the big play that got him down close. I think that big play left him reeling a little bit. They didn't recover from it. And you know, they always talk about having to have a short memory on defense after a big play against you. Looks like their memory was a little too long there.
The Bucs take over first and 10 at their own 25-yard line.
The Bucs offense set to begin their next possession. They trail offense, first time to touch the ball in quarter three, and we'll see what they can do.
And I can't wait to see what they have planned, because some teams script to start a half. Other teams just go, okay, these are the sequence of plays we want to run. These things worked well for us. But sometimes they throw in that big chunk play right away.
Shocker.
Try and get after them early and try and create a big play to give themselves some momentum.
See what they have up their sleeve. And he's just going to get rid of this thing to no one here. He throws it away, and now it's third.
Down and 13.
This offense in desperate need of a conversion as they come up on third down. From the gun, here's Watson. And that will be incomplete.
That's an excellent job right there on third down. Like any defense, you never want to let them get anything started. And that would have been a first down. Instead, you saw the contact on time, no penalty. And before this drive could get wings, it's fourth down.
Looks like the offense is going to take another shot here. They're going on fourth and 13. It's caught. Jones. A big seam, and he might go all the way.
Ooh,
touchdown, Tampa Bay. Marvin Jones, 78 yards. And the Bucs are able to cut in now to that deficit. That certainly went against the traditional ways of playing football, but who cares? Look at the result. Big touchdown.
They went for it on their own side of the 50. So there's conservative, there's aggressive, and there's really aggressive, which is what we just saw there. Tip of the cap to them.
Gold with the extra point, and the lead will be cut down to 14. And that one will bounce out of the back of the end zone, so we will start here at the 25. The Panthers out there and ready to begin their next drive. Their lead down from 21 to 14, but still sitting in a great spot. Up two scores here in the third quarter. And he's going to be intercepted a third time. Buda Baker with a pick. And he is not quite going to make it all the way in. They'll mark him down right about the one-yard line. So now he's equaled his interception total from a week ago. Remember, Charles, he had three last week.
And you know, all week long, he vowed to take that number down. Told the guys on the team, don't worry, things are going to pick up. I've got this. But he is in a major league rut right now. Let's see if his teammates can pick him up along the way.
You're right. He talked about being cool, calm, collective, rebounding. Not rebounding right here. Now, they struggled to get him rolling on the ground in the first half, and that's sort of continuing here in the third quarter.
Yeah, but I don't think it's time to abandon the running game. I would say keep feeding the horse, and I believe he'll eventually reward them, especially as we get deeper in the game.
They'll try to run this one in, and he's in. Touchdown, Buccaneers. Rashad Perriman. His second touchdown on the season. And the Bucks capitalize on the short field as they take it in for six. And that'll cut the lead down now to a touchdown.
Makes the score Panthers 26, Buccaneers 19. Robbie Gould.
After the touchdown, it's Robbie Gould now to kick it away.
And this will make it into the end zone. And he'll be stopped right around where he would have been had he gone down to a knee, maybe a yard shy of there at the 24.
4 yard line.
This Carolina offense at the line, ready to go. And their lead cut in half by that touchdown a moment ago. They are up 7 as they begin this drive, 1st and 10. Trying to shake off the interception from the last drive. He'll look to throw. Throwing deep for Galladay. That one will be incomplete. He caught it but could not stay in bounds for the long connection. So this will be accepted as it moves the offense backwards. Now Carr, after the incomplete pass, brings him up 2nd and 10. Throwing again. Carr. Another throw for Galladay. This one complete. And up to the 35 before they're able to knock him down. 12 yards there and a first down.
1st and 10 at the 35.
Working from the gun, it's Carr.
Nothing
and his
here.
Pass is
Nothing
intercepted
here.
For the 4th time today. Picked off at the 36. And it's a pick 6. He brings it back to the house for a Buccaneer TD.
It goes without saying, but I'm going to say it anyway. That's a ball he would like to have back, and it lands right in the lap of the defender from there. He doesn't have very far to go before he gets to the end zone, and he got there in a hurry.
Gold able to tack on the extra point, and that will tie our game here in the 3rd. So a tie ball game here as the kick's away. And that one will bounce out of the back of the end zone, so we will start here at the 25. The Panthers out there and ready to begin their next drive. And their lead has evaporated in this 3rd quarter. It's tied once more as they begin with a 1st and 10. He'll get this one to Galladay. He's tackled a yard short of the marker. Good gain of 9 on 1st down.
Brings up 2nd and 1 at the 34-yard line.
To throw again on 2nd down. Carr flushed out right. On the run, he'll let it go deep. Oh, wide open, complete. And he is finally out of bounds, but he gets all the way down right around the 20. So that one will be accepted. And the Bucs with an extra defender in the secondary now on 3rd down. Shotgun now for Carr. And that's going to be caught. It's Rico Gafford. And he is going to have a Panthers 1st down as they're able to convert by plenty there on 3rd and 1.
At the 41-yard line.
On 1st down, Carr. Eluding the pressure right. On the run, he'll let this go deep. It's caught inside the 25. And he takes this just a few yards shy of the red zone before going out. 36 yards on the play. So the big play gets him all the way down to the outskirts of the red zone here for 1st and 10. And now here is another interception. Picked up by Mikel Roby Coleman. I think you and I were a little surprised back earlier in the game when he threw his 2nd interception. I mean, who would have thought a quarterback of his caliber picked now 5 times?
It's beyond stunning to me because we're used to that with maybe a quarterback with less experience or less talent. But a quarterback of his caliber, I can't believe what we've just seen.
Absolutely. If you would have told me this coming into the ballgame, I would have said never. Not in a million years, but here we go.
At his own 4-yard line.
That 1st down play, all you want to do is wedge out any type of space and try and create enough room. If you have to run the punter out there, he can successfully complete the punt.
Yeah, didn't get a ton there, but at least some positive yardage. And And that false start penalty certainly not helping their cause here. Second down and long. Following the penalty, here's Gordon. And he'll get this only up to about the 3-yard line. An important play right here, 3rd and 10.
And I would expect pressure here.
2 runs in a row, but only 2 yards to show for it. Caught on the right side by Jones.
Watson's pass.
And he is going to have the Buccaneers first down as they're able to get the 3rd down conversion. It's a gain of 16, first down Tampa Bay. This is Gordon. He'll be dropped at the 25 after a gain of 6. The last run got 6, now 2nd and 4.
6-yard pickup brings up 2nd and 4.
To throw is Watson. And seeing nowhere to throw, he chucks this one away from Harb. Incomplete. Now it's 3rd down.
I think he had to unload that one before he wanted to. He was right up in his grill. I think he was a dentist there without a license, don't you?
Just not enough time for the play to develop. Just lucky it wasn't a fumble, really. From the gun on 3rd, Watson. And they're able to get this one across the 35. 50 catches for him now on the year, and he's got a 1st down.
First down, Buccaneers.
Out of the gun, Watson. Escaping the pressure right. And he just gets rid of it. Throws it away. A wise move there. Looked like nobody open. Now 2nd down.
They've given up a few 1st downs on this drive, but getting the incompletion there, that should give them something to build on and maybe turn the tide.
From the shotgun now, here's an inside give. And for a 2nd straight play, just nowhere to go thanks to this Carolina defense. It'll go as a loss of 1 yard, so now they deal with 3rd and 11. Throwing on 3rd down, Watson. Flush to his right. Looking for his tight end on the corner, it's complete. And he is going to have a Bucs 1st down as they're able to get the 3rd down conversion. Some good games going on in the early window. This might be the best of the bunch. From the shotgun now, here's an inside give. And he is tackled inside the 4. Another nice gain, 13 yards that time, and another 1st down.
And the Buccaneer 1st down.
A shotgun snap for Watson. Steps away to his left. And he'll toss this one incomplete. Seeing no options, he throws it away. Got out of the pocket. Didn't look like he had anybody open, Charles, so just gets rid of it.
And a good play by him. If no one's open and you don't have a running lane that you want to take, make the right choice. Get rid of it. Live to fight another down.
And this one's going to go the wrong way. Losing yardage back at the 42. 3rd and long, it's Watson. And that is incomplete.
A lot of times it's that first read that you have. Maybe you get it in pre-snap. He locked in on his target, but he was covered quite well, and that one's incomplete.
So they're forced to punt on 4th as this one's away. Oh, I nearly broke that one. As it stands, though, a heck of a 36-yard run back. And the offense will take over with a new set of downs. This Carolina offense at the line, ready to go. Excellent job by their defense to force the punt and provide them with this opportunity, all tied in the 4th quarter. Kenny Galladay, the intended receiver, and that'll bring up 2nd down. They don't get the hookup there, but you really have to marvel at how precise he's been throwing the football these last couple weeks.
Oh, that's the perfect word for it, precise, because if you're at 70% or better 2 weeks in a row, you have a job as long as you want one in this league, won't you? I mean, let's face it, it's not just West Coast offense either. He's putting the ball downfield as well.
4 yards the gain, and it'll bring up a 3rd down. From the gun, it's Carr. And this is going to be intercepted. Picked off at the 33. And nothing but green grass here, middle of the field. And it's a pick six. He brings it back to the house for a Buccaneer TD. So that is two pick sixes he's thrown in this football game. Now you take those away, Charles, it's a completely different situation.
It totally is, but guess what? They have to deal with what they have now, okay? So they can't just mentally go, well, if we hadn't thrown those pick sixes, we'd be okay. Here's where you are. Here's where you're going to battle. But guess what? They're not out of it by any stretch of the imagination.
And he can't field it cleanly. It's loose. And this will not be returned. It'll come out to the 25.
At their own 25-yard line.
The Panthers out there and ready to begin their next drive. And can they regroup? That's the question. The pick six hurt, no doubt, but this is still a one-score game here in the fourth. A good start to the drive here as that's caught out on the left side. And he takes us beyond the 35 before going out of bounds. A gain of 11 to kick off the drive, and it's a quick first down. From the gun, Carr flushed out right. And that'll be incomplete. Another throw there off the mark, and obviously he's battled all of the interceptions. Things just haven't been true to form for him. I don't know. What do you think's going on out there, CD?
That's a great question, and my suspicion is he's been coached really well to not show that he's having a problem. You know, they always tell you no matter what, you keep throwing the football with confidence. Well, we're not seeing a confident thrower right now. He's off balance, the passing game's off balance, and the defense is taking advantage.
They do get a yard there, but only a yard. Leaves him with third and nine looming.
Brings up third down and
throwing his car on third down. Eluding the pressure right. He may try and run for this. And he'll go out of bounds, it appears, right at the 45. Give him 8 yards that time on the scramble, and now fourth down.
Okay, he's not going to get the first down, but this is still a nice job of buying some time and then running to get to the sideline and get out of bounds and avoid the big hit.
Gonna go on fourth down, and he'll find Galladay. That's complete.
Good.
And he's got the first down yardage as he takes it down to the 49. And now the Bucs deciding to take a timeout defensively. It's just their first. They'll be down to two remaining as we step aside here in the fourth quarter. Operating from the gun, Carr. Fighting his safety valve here. That's complete. And he gets it inside the 35 and just shy of the 30. The catch and run good for 18 and a first down.
31-yard line.
From the gun, Carr. It's caught on the right side, Williams. And he's taken down, but not before reaching the 10-yard line. A good pickup there, 21 yards.
That's another Panthers first down.
Carr now on first down. He's got it for a Panther touchdown. Preston Williams with his second touchdown of the game, number 8 on the season. And the Panthers are now an extra point away from tying up this game.
I know Paul Revere talked about by land or by sea, right? You know, one by land, two by sea. He didn't mention air because right now we're seeing a big-time performance, aren't we? That's two touchdowns so far in this game.
Where'd you pull that one from?
And, you know, every now and then I actually listened in history class.
And you're just a scholar all the way around. You're reading all the time. I like that you fit that into the broadcast.
You know, I just grab a nugget when I can.
At their own 25-yard line.
The Bucs offense set to begin their next possession. And they will be looking to answer the touchdown. Their defense just surrendered. Still a good chunk of time remaining here in the fourth quarter and a chance to regain the lead in a tight one.
They'll get a nice chunk there on the first down run, and it's second and four.
Second and four.
Watson now to throw.
Ready to show
and
on
he's
up,
got his man on the out route. Jones hit and the ball's out. And it's picked up by the Panthers. And they'll start out with great field position at the 47-yard line in enemy territory. So after the fumble recovery, it's Carr. He's going to flip one out here to his running back. 14 yards, good for a Panther first down.
Panther! First and
flag comes in. This might be a free play. He's going to air one out. And he takes it into the end zone across the chalk. Now there is a flag down, but I think that's offsides on the defense.
Yeah, I think that's going to stand, partner.
So a big play coming for the Panthers. They'll go for two. Operating from the gun. Carr. And it's intercepted at the goal line. A great read and it's picked off. Defenders giving chase, but I don't think they're going to get there. And he will bring this all the way back out to midfield.
40. Buccaneers 33.
Now after the touchdown, it's Zuerlein. He'll kick it away. And that one will bounce out of the back of the end zone, so we will start here at the 25. The Bucs offense set to begin their next possession. And a fumble last time. Ball security. Talk about it all the time in the National Football League. They've got to be better at it on this drive.
Don't you think that when every team gets together for the first time, I don't care if it's OTAs, mini camps, first day of camp in the regular season, ball security comes up about, what, the second sentence of the coach's address?
And there's so many drills focus on that.
All the time, and they do drills to make it even tougher to simulate game situations. Doesn't always work out, though.
And incomplete as he was knocked as he threw it, and it took the ball off course. So now second and 10 after the incompletion on first down. Throwing again is Watson. He's going to let it fly. We've got a one-score game with inside of 2 minutes remaining. So it's Buccaneer football as we welcome you back. They face a critical third down now, needing a score here in the late going. Now it's Watson. And he comes back with one complete. And he is going to have the Buccaneers first down as they're able to get the third down conversion. Watson looks to throw again. And seeing no options, he just tosses this one away incomplete. Now that'll bring up second down.
It's now second and 10 at the 30-yard line.
Watson now to throw. The left side completion to Jones. And they're going to have another first down as the tackle's made at the Panthers' 20-yard line. 11 yards for number 11.
Buccaneers.
From the red zone now, Watson. And that's going to be incomplete. Too tough to hold on to that one. It's second down.
And that's one of those plays where it's hard to keep two eyes on the football when you know the contact's coming, let alone getting two hands around it, hugging it to your body, and absorbing the hit, even for those big tight ends who you would think could absorb that contact.
He'll look to throw. And that is incomplete. A lot of force bearing down on him there. He could not hang on. It's third down.
Third and long coming up defensively. You pressure the quarterback or Drake ball over the passing lane?
Yes, that's exactly what you do. It's both because they're not mutually exclusive. They may have been at one time in football, but not anymore. You want to have that pressure. If you have a big-time pass rusher, send him after the quarterback and then make sure you blanket the field.
To throw. It's caught. Jones. He takes it across for the touchdown, and they've taken the lead late in the final minute of the fourth.
Wow. Wow. And what a weapon he is at the tight end spot, because when they throw him the football downfield, they count on him getting additional yardage almost every time. And that's exactly what he did there. Caught that, ran with it, all the way to the end zone.
So here comes the kickoff now, all even here in this fourth quarter. Taking it about the one. And he brings this out past the 20 to the 24.
Over first and 10 at their own 24-yard line.
This Carolina offense at the line, ready to go. They'd like to avoid overtime here, so maybe they can work the sidelines. But then defensively, how do they adjust to that if they do work the sideline?
It's the old leverage game, and we usually talk about leverage at the line of scrimmage, right? Who's going to win with the low blocking and everything that goes along with that? But in this case, you're trying as a defender to leverage them towards the middle of the field, not let them get to the sidelines and try and tackle them inbounds in order to run the clock out.
Chess match here late. And they nearly get this all the way to midfield. Mark him down at the 49. Now the Panthers going to use the first of their timeouts.
The 49-yard line.
Carr to throw. As they get it with 16 seconds remaining on the clock. Throw right side, complete to Williams. Another big gainer that time. This one goes for 19 yards from the 32 now. Here's first and 10.
First and 10 at the 32-yard line.
To throw, Carr. And down he goes. A Buccaneer sack. And we've got a timeout.
Darius Leonard.
9 seconds remaining.
At the 43-yard line.
Well, they're in some hot water now after that sack. It's second and 21. Now Carr. Got some real estate inside the 30. And this one complete to Gafford. And now they're going to get the timeout. So a huge play, has him in field goal range with a chance to possibly send this one to OT. And a timeout comes in. The whistles blow with 3 seconds remaining. So it'll all come down to the booming right leg of Greg Zuerlein. With 3 seconds to go, this for the win. And this one is right through. And the Panthers have won the football game.
Panthers 43.
A little drama there at the end, but really this thing was already decided. The late points get scored, and then it ends on the kickoff.
And I'm right there with you, partner. At the end of the game, they knew what they had to do. Just make sure you don't cough up the football at the end. Just take care of it, and victory was theirs, and that's exactly what they did.
So for Carolina, the great run they've been on continues as they move to 9-1 now. And they'll have another home date next week as the Detroit Lions come to town. Meanwhile, for Tampa Bay, it's a loss that'll drop them back to 500 through 10 games. And they'll have a chance at redemption next week at home against the Los Angeles Rams. And for Charles Davis and our entire crew here at EA Sports, I'm Brandon Gordon, saying so long, everybody.
Someone put me out cause I'm on fire. I can't give up about what they say. They've been searching for that thing to get them higher. You can't catch my drip, can't catch my wave.
Damn, Kane, you done kill Abel. Unbalanced land, trying to keep the people stable. The way I feel, I might f*** it all up. The way you feel, you might do it for the buck. All black, born to be a rebel. After this, I might go and water down the devil. Listen to everything around me, I can't see. You picked a dozen roses and left them in Galilee. Rolling thunder, don't hear my cry, don't let alibis pass you. If I finally starting to realize, never give up and coincide. I can't watch TV, it's all a lot. Tired of trying, go ahead and fly. Everybody want a straight answer, but media keep us blind. A good heart is not hard to find. Why do people try to define infrastructure? Right, I don't got time. Infrastructure, right, I don't got time. I could talk to. We're talking about your brother protecting the sons and daughters from political mislaughter.
Someone put me out cause I'm on fire. I can't give up about what they say. They've been searching for that thing to get them higher. You can't catch my drift.
Never play by the rules. They gon' try to intrude, pushing the multitude. They be quick to accuse when you got different views. Just know you gon' pay the price. Best off the item you choose. Many times in the culture, hit you with them K Ultra. I knew you was a vulture. Holy Ghost, get the ushers. No, I can't trust you. Shock you, deny you, fluster. Crashing down, I was cluttered. Doing this so subtle, falling out through the rubble. Remember this in jungle. The top, I was gonna get something. The middle, gotta stay hunting. Why the rush up for nothing? 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 Agitated illusion, only built for confusion. The institution, modern day execution. Think I knew the solution. Maybe not should I do it, but just put it in the music. Just put it in the music.
Someone put me out cause I'm on fire. I can't give up about what they say. They've been searching for that thing to get them higher. You can't catch my drift, can't catch my wave.
You're brave.